To a bowl, add in 1/2 cup of semolina or suji. Then we add in 1 cup of powdered sugar. This is just so that the sugar gets mixed well very quickly. And then next we add in 1 cup of maida. You may also add in 3 to 4 cloves of cardamom without its outer shell. This is just for the flavor. And we are here, we are going to use milk for mixing this mixture up. You may also use water in case you are allergic to milk. We have to bring this mixture to a pouring consistency, just like your dosa batter or appam batter consistency. Let the mixture rest for at least 1 hour in a cool place. To a boil pan, add 750 ml of milk. And let it boil. Ensure to stir the milk occasionally so that the milk doesn't get burnt. To the boiled milk, add in 3 to 4 cloves of cardamom. Once the milk is reduced to 250 to 300 ml, let's add in the sugar. So here we are going to give around 4 to 5 tablespoons of sugar. Let's not put too much sugar in the initial phase, as we will be adding in the milkmaid at the later stage. You may use any condensed milk for that matter. This entire process of reduction of milk takes about 1 to 1.5 hours. So you have to keep the flames on a very low to ensure the milk doesn't get burnt, and keep on stirring it continuously, maybe every 5 minutes at least once. For the making the pati shapta, we'll be taking a hot pan. Add a little bit of ghee to the pan so that the pan gets greased. To it, add around 30 ml of the mixture what you had made before. Rotate it slowly so that you get a thin crepe out of the mixture. Once the mixture is almost cooked, we will add in the dessert at the center. So here we are adding in Mysore Pak and Dharwad Peda. So you may add any dessert, any dry dessert for that matter, of your choice. Then let's fold the sides and take out the pati shapta. Here we are going to serve the pati shapta along with the special rabdi we had made. So it is not a compulsion to have a rabdi, but it enhances the flavor of a pati shapta. We will garnish the pati shapta with some freshly chopped nuts. Here I am adding in pistachios, almonds and cashew nuts.